25. Frank Costello, The Departed. To be honest, there is nothing special about Frank Costello in The Departed, except the rat scene, of course. But the fact that Jack Nicholson finally portrays a gangster is enough for us to include Costello on our list. 24. Luciano, Hoodlum. Hoodlum is a fictional story that includes the names of many legendary gangsters. The story takes us back to 1930s, where African-American gangsters struggle for dominion and power against Dutch Schultz. However, it's another man who steals the show here, Luci Luciano. And truth be told, being Italian gives you the clear edge in playing gangster films. 23. Bricktop, Snatch. Bricktop is one of the many epic roles Guy Ritchie invented in his films to portray a powerful crime lord who controls and fixes illegal boxing bouts in London and loves to feed the victims of his violent crimes to pigs. How could someone be so cruel, sadistic, and at the same time, hilarious? 22. Pippi de Lena, The Last Don. Before The Sopranos and James Gandolfini, there was The Last Don and Joe Montana. Maybe the comparison is a bit off, but still, this superb TV miniseries from the 90s is classic material when it comes to mafia-themed shows, and Joe Montana as Pippi de Lena was pretty awesome. 21. Benjamin Lefty Ruggiero, Donnie Brasco. Lefty, as Benjamin Ruggiero was known to mafia circles, was a real person and a soldier in the Bonanno crime family. The masses got introduced to him, however, in the film Donnie Brasco, where the mighty Al Pacino portrays Lefty in a way that makes him look more like a victim, when in reality, Ruggiero was responsible for the death of 26 people. 20. Sal Big Pussy Bonpensiero, The Sopranos. Joe Montana had Jerry Rice. Dean Martin had Jerry Lewis. Paul Simon had Art Garfunkel. And Tony Soprano would never be who he was if he didn't have Sal Big Pussy's Bonpensiero to look after him. 19. Frankie, The Business. This low-budget but unexpectedly good British gangster flick by Nick Love introduces us to Frankie and takes place in sunny Spain in the 80s. This totally amateur wannabe gangster dresses like a tennis star of the era, drives his boss's luxury car, and does all the menial errands in order to climb the ranks. We like them simply because this boy is all a gangster should never be. 18. Mr. Blonde, Reservoir Dogs. Reservoir Dogs was one of the early and more awesome works of Quentin Tarantino. And even though we could easily select any gangster from this brilliant film, we're gonna stick with the sadistic psychopath Mr. Blonde, simply because we recently discovered that he was the brother of Vincent Vega from Pulp Fiction, which followed shortly after Reservoir Dogs. Be honest, did you know that? We sure didn't. 17. Sonny Lospecchio, A Bronx Tale. Sonny Lospecchio is a character in the 1993's A Bronx Tale, which was directed by Robert De Niro, and was interpreted as the autobiographical story of the legendary Italian-American actor. As for Sonny, he's doubtless one of the coolest and best-dressed gangsters in film, and even though he wasn't Calogero's father, he's the one who's remembered as the caring father figure. 16. Big Chris, Lock, Stuck, and Two Smoking Barrels. Guy Ritchie once again pleasantly surprises us by hiring a retired footballer and certified badass, Vinnie Jones, who in his film debut is so good and convincing to the point that his character, Big Chris, is now considered an icon among crime gangster film fans. 15. George Young Blow. The real George Young, whom Johnny Depp portrayed so accurately in Blow, was released from prison on June 2, 2014, after serving nearly 20 years for drug smuggling. Young was a major player in the cocaine trade in the United States during the 1970s, and we must admit that never again has a gangster lifestyle resembled a rock star so much in both film and real life. 14. Jacques Mesrine, L'Instinct de Mort. The man who escaped from prison more times than Houdini escaped from a straitjacket was responsible for numerous murders, bank robberies, burglaries, and kidnappings in France and Canada, where he was considered, in both countries, the number one public enemy. 13. Leon the Professional. Technically, Leon isn't a mobster or a gangster, but a hitman who works for the mob and has some standards that he never breaks, such as killing women or kids. Hey, can't go wrong with that, right? I guess. 12. Johnny Quid, Rock and Rolla. Johnny Quid is an underground musician who tries to make it big, and a junkie who fakes his own death so he can help his music sales. Lenny Cole, the head mobster of London's mob, is Johnny's stepfather, and that makes Johnny the only legit heir to Cole's vast legacy, if you will, in the world of crime. 11. John Dillinger, Public Enemies. John Herbert Dillinger was an American gangster and bank robber during the Depression, and it's estimated that the gang he was leading robbed over 24 banks and 4 police stations. There have been several films made about his story, but in our opinion, none was as good as Michael Mann's Public Enemies. 10. Carlito, Carlito's Way. Carlito Brigante is a Puerto Rican ex-convict trying to make a decent living and stay out of trouble, but a series of unfortunate circumstances and a bad social environment won't let him do the right thing. Al Pacino takes the role to another level and portrays him as only he could, as one of the most sympathetic, charming, and humane gangsters in film history. 9. Tommy DeVito, Goodfellas. The most fascinating part of Tommy DeVito's story, a role based on a gangster named Thomas Anthony, Two Gun Tommy, DeSimone, is that Joe Pesci did not physically resemble the tall, muscular Two Gun Tommy at all. However, Pesky's portrayal was between 90 and 95% accurate, according to police reports. 8. Vincent Vega, Pulp Fiction. Vincent Vega is not just another mobster, but the role that resurrected John Travolta's career. Vincent is a hitman working for mob boss Marcellus Wallace, and look-wise, he resembles more like a rockabilly music star a la Elvis than your typical mafia man. 7. Fat Tony, The Simpsons. Marion Anthony, Fat Tony De Amico, is a gangster and the underboss of the Springfield Mafia, and we were first introduced to him in the 3rd season of The Simpsons. He is voiced by Joe Mantegna, and there's no doubt that this character has made gangsters look and sound cool, even in the world of animation. 6. Nikolai, Eastern Promises. You really don't want to mess with any mafia of any kind, but you definitely don't want to mess with the Russian Mafia. Nikolai in Eastern Promises is the perfect example of a Russian mafia character, and if you have seen the film, then you definitely know what I'm talking about. 5. Michael Corleone, The Godfather. Michael Corleone is the main character of the Godfather trilogy, portrayed by the legendary Al Pacino, who was twice nominated for an Academy Award for his portrayal, but unfortunately never won. This role has been named the 11th most iconic villain in film history by the American Film Institute, but we're pretty sure that he ranks even higher in the hearts of movie fans. 4. Kaiser Soze. Kaiser Soze is probably the most mysterious, vicious, supernatural, and dark mobster in film history, at least according to his self-description, or to be more accurate, as described by his alter ego, Roger Verbal Kint. After all these years, we're still trying to figure out if he was a man or the devil himself. 3. Tony Soprano, The Sopranos. Tony Soprano is without a doubt the most famous and charismatic TV mobster in history, and this role in the outrageously popular HBO drama The Sopranos made James Gandolfini one of the highest earning and most awarded TV actors for one role. But unfortunately, he left us way too soon. 2. Tony Montana, Scarface. Tony Montana is legally to blame for possibly the most famous quote in the history of any gangster and mafia film ever. And of course, I'm referring to the epic, "Say hello to my little friend." 1. Vito Corleone, The Godfather. Vito Corleone is another character from Mario Puzo's novel, The Godfather, and its film adaptation. The role has been portrayed by Robert De Niro and the one and only Marlon Brando in the first film of the trilogy. Premiere magazine named Vito Corleone the greatest movie character in history, and I don't think many can disagree with that.
Liking our lists? Be sure to subscribe by pressing the button at the top corner of your screen. And if you're still itching for more awesome lists, click on these nifty thumbnails created by yours truly, and be sure to show us some love by liking, sharing, and commenting.